Croeso I Dyffryn Mynbyr, welcome to Dyffryn Mynbyr, a National Trust farm right at the headwaters of the Upper Conwy catchment in Snowdonia. Now this place might look like a rugged, resilient landscape, but it's actually under threat from climate change, like so many other places. But I'm going to show you how we're working tirelessly to help keep this place special for generations to come. My name's Dewi Davis, and I'm a project manager for National Trust in Snowdonia. I'm proud to say that I've lived and worked in this area all my life, and this place is really special to me. We're at Carog Farm in Cwmpymachno in Snowdonia, which is right at the head of the Upper Conwy catchment. The reason we're here is to look at some of the flood alleviation work we've done here. So we're walking along an embankment, what was an embankment up to my shoulder height before we came in and removed it. So we had big machines here a couple of years ago, just stripping away 2,500 tons of material and allowing the river to my left here, Afon Machno, to reconnect with its floodplain. So the field here on my right-hand side was protected for agricultural reasons from the flooding from Afon Machno. But what's happened there, obviously, is that all of that water coming down the system has been kept within the channel, and that just shoots off down the catchment. And now, hopefully, we've given it space. So we've made space for water by allowing water in a flood event to come over and into this floodplain. For villages like Llanrwst, downstream of Afon Machno in the Conwy Valley, this is really good news because they are really susceptible to flooding, and this will help reduce flooding on their doorstep. One of the difficulties about doing this kind of work is the ability to show what you've done or to measure the effectiveness of the work. But this is quite a simple method of doing it. This is a maximum level gauge. And this measures the total flood water coming out of the river in a flood event. We've got these dotted across the floodplain, and that shows you the total volume of water that's taken out of that river system in a flood and stored in the floodplain. And when the flood dissipates or recedes, the water just trickles back into the river. So it takes that peak off the flood curve again.
And enw fi ydi Bethan Beach, fi ydi swyddog y prosiect Uwch Conwy. A dweud y gwir, dwi ar secondiad am 2 mlynedd o Cyfoeth Naturiol Cymru i'r ymbrydoleth I weithio ar y prosiect. A dwi'n ffodus iawn yn cael neu hynny, oherwydd dwi'n lwcus iawn I gael mwynhau'n waith, gweithio mewn ardal mor braf, a gael gweithio fo cymunedau a contractwyr a bobl lleol er mwyn gwella'r cynefinoedd hynny ychydig fwy I geisio atal newid hinsawdd yma yn Gogledd Cymru. A dyma ni heddiw ar y Mignaint. Dwi'n mynd bell o Llyn Conwy, sydd wrth gwrs yn darddiad i'r Afon Conwy. Ond y rheswm dyn ni yma heddiw, dyn ni wedi dod I edrych ar y mawndir. Erbyn ŵan, dyn ni'n dall bod mawn iach yn cymryd carbon dioxide o'r awyr ac yn ei gloio yn y mawn yn barhaol. Ond, er mwyn I hynny ddigwydd, mae angen i'r mawndir fod yn wlyb. Yn anffodus, yn ystod y ganrif diwetha, gath nifer fawr o ffosydd I roi yn y Mignaint a mewn ardaloedd eraill i'w sychio. Dyn ni'n gwrth wneud hynny trwy ail gael y ffosydd. Mae hynny'n annog y micwyn, sef y mwsog arbennig yma I dyfu. Hwn ydy beth sy'n cloi y carbon o'r awyr I biclo fo ac yn ei osod o yn y ddaear. Mae hyn yn cadw mwy o carbon a hefyd mae'r broses o gael y mawndir yn iach yn gallu dal mwy o ddŵr yn ôl yn yr ucheldir a lleihau y dŵr yn llifo lawr I achosi llifogydd yn y gaeaf. Felly mae'n dda o ran cloi carbon a hefyd arafu llif y dŵr.
So here's one place we've done some work to address some of the impacts of climate change. This is Nant y Gwrid, and the riverbank behind me you can see is eroded. Now, where I'm standing now used to look like that too, but we've reprofiled this section of riverbank. So instead of looking like a vertical face, easily eroded, it's been reprofiled back to a nice gentle angle. So when the water actually rises, it has somewhere to go. So we've made space for water here. What we've done also is to fence off the riverbank, increasing the roughness here. So there's no animals grazing here now. The grass is allowed to grow and it binds the soil and slows the flow of water into the river. we've also planted trees here. We've done that as well on the hillsides all around me, and that slows the flow of water coming down the mountain into the river system, which then goes down into the valleys lower down where there are towns impacted by flooding. So hopefully we'll see some good results there. So this is a fixed photo frame, and it's a really useful piece of kit for rangers and volunteers to be able to do time-lapse recording. It shows us, not in a scientific way, but in a really useful visual way, of some of the changes and the impacts of climate change here. Here at the National Trust, we are very fortunate to have such special places in our care, but there's never been a more important time to ensure that they remain protected for everyone, forever.